Good evening, everybody. How the devil are you? It's been one of those days today. Today, I'm on the coffee today because I'm tired. I've got Canadian coffee made with one of these thing plungers and it smells and tastes like maple. My brother brought it back from Canada with him. So, yeah, it's all good. How is everybody tonight? wrong answers only. Okay, so why have I been so tired today? It's because I got up at 7 to do the Spitfire. I didn't finish building the Spitfire till 12, and then I had to upload it to YouTube and stuff, so I think it went out about 1 o'clock today. And hello, Christian from Grantham.
Let's give it up big time. Hello, Christian from Grantham. Now let's get cracking.
Now, what happened was that when I first started it, the propeller didn't work at all. So I took a bit of the wing off, had a look at the plug, and I noticed some of the wires had come out the back of the connector, and I couldn't push them back in. So I cut both the plugs off and soldered the wires together. Propeller works. Then I noticed that the gears were doing the complete opposite thing. Now, apparently, this lead will change the direction of the motor and stop that happening so that they'll be down when they're meant to be down. Yeah, it didn't do nothing. So that didn't work. So not quite sure what to do about that. And my latest problem tonight is the plane is working fine now, believe it or not. It's working absolutely fine. The lifters. Something's gone wrong with a sensor on the lifter. So one has now lifted all the way up and it won't go back down again. So I take it apart, put it back down, and then it just lifts itself back up again because the limiter at the top is not working. So I'm getting to the point now where I think, you know what? I'm going to just display it as a static model. I've still got like 6 stages left to do. But God, it's driving me nuts. It is. It's driving me absolutely nuts. It's probably the most... It's been one of the most... It's one of my favourite builds, the Spitfire was, until the last 9 stages when it all went to pot. It all went as bad as this thing here, which we're working on tonight. Now, this is the engine, which does look really nice. Don't get me wrong. Looks absolutely amazing. To get to this stage, though, you have to walk through you have to walk through hell. You have to do like the... How many Trials of Hercules was it, Mrs. Worldaway? And you have to do all those Trials of Hercules just to get to that stage. We're going to be adding 3 details to this tonight, and then we get to work on the bodywork. So finally, I get to leave this engine alone and do something fun. But we're probably still going to be having loads of things kept behind. But yeah, so that Spitfire... Where's the good-looking host gone? Very good, Philip. but as for the Spitfire, I said, everything works on it now. Apart from the guns, I couldn't confirm if the guns work. It makes a noise, but I don't know if the lights come on. But those lifters are bugging me now. It's bugging me. I'm looking at it now, and it's the... Scrap it. I'm thinking of scrapping it. Not the Spitfire. The Spitfire looks amazing. But having all the whistles and the... ups and downs and how big a room it takes up. I don't know. Is it worth it? Hello, Craig. How's it going? I've got some things to do today. First off, I want to thank, I don't know if you're watching on the live stream, William and Victoria Dickey. They came to the man cave today. So I've spent all afternoon with these peasant folk from Utah and they're over in the UK at the moment. And I had a really, really good time just chatting, killing the breeze and all of that. So that's what I've been doing this afternoon. I love meeting people. So, you know, next time people are passing, we perhaps arrange a view of the workshop and have a chat. We'll figure it out. You had septic issues. That's a little bit more information than I need, Craig. Septic issues. Oh, my God. So, Robert, yes, it's probably going to be a car crash tonight. Just so you know. Robert, I am going to be working on your plaque. And talking about plaques, throw it out the window. I should do. At least we got a video out of it today with it working. So I can prove it did kind of work. I've been doing some plaques. So Will's Workshop, if you're watching, look, I've redone it with the font there. So I'm probably going to be sending this one to you because I can't get a bigger plaque on my build plate. So I've got to paint these, by the way. John Stevie and Sophia Arms, still got to paint these and varnish them. And I know I've seen you in chat tonight. There you go, Jamesy boy. How's that with the Scottish flag on as well? That's how yours is going to look, Robert. You'll have the Scottish flag on there. So once again, I've got to get those. I've got to get those sanded and painted. So that's all good. Steve, of course I can wish Dawn a happy birthday. Even better, look, I can put a little happy birthday sign on there. Happy birthday, Dawn, and I hope you have an absolutely great day. I do like having my overlays ready to hand, which I was surprised tonight because I was just trying to dig out all the parts for the Ferrari that I'm going to need tonight because they're never in one place. I've got another thing, which I always like to show you all successes and stuff like that. Paul and Noah Phillips have just finished the DB5 and sent me a picture. Congratulations on that. Obviously, the hardest bit of that is getting it together, the two halves together, but you've done that beautifully by the look of it. It looks absolutely brilliant. So well done, you two. That looks brilliant. It's a shame I haven't got one myself now. Old Christian came and picked that up. Christian Buxton. So it's in his house. Now I don't have a DB5 here anymore. So it's all cool. Hi, Wayne. I've just seen... I'd just like to mention... Okay. You can mention it. I don't know what you're going to say. The Svee Wheel is painting you a guitar live stream on Saturday if anyone would like to watch. Wow. I bet that's cool. I've seen the Frankenstein or the old horror movies guitar that he did. I think that looks absolutely brilliant. Oh, cool. I'm glad you're happy with that, Jamesy boy. It's all good. And also, we've got a little matter of this to give away. Now, we're going to be doing this randomly, but I'm not just giving this away. I'm going to be giving some pop culture items away from this as well. And it was open to worldwide. And I did say, put your message with hashtag Mrs. Welder Wayne on her video this week. What I've done is I'm using a program called Hadzi that looks like that. And what it does is it picks random comments out that have that hashtag. Sometimes I have to flick through it because it's not perfect. So I'm going to actually pick three prizes today because I've got quite a bit of loot crate stuff and pop culture stuff to send out. So what I'll do is if you hear your name, then email me. Alternatively, I will comment on Mrs. Welder Wayne's to get in touch with me. And if you want to know my email address, it is... No idea. Stand by. I did have an email over. Mail time? No, it's not that. There you go. Email overlay. That's my email address. So just email me there. So the winner of that Back to the Future minis and also some of the other pop culture items is... You've got to be kidding me. Robert Beveridge. You've won that and some of the pop culture items. Oh my God, and I've just seen you in chat. So Robert's first. Who's second? Stand by. Got to keep clicking around them. There we go. We've got Anthony Oates. Great video. You're a natural at this. You're second. Mrs. Welder Wayne, can you write these down so I can remember? Robert Beveridge, Anthony Oates, and we're going to do one more. Chris Morris. Very concise and easy to follow instructions. I never would have thought I would have enjoyed watching this sort of content. I'm definitely looking forward to the next one. There you go. Chris Morris, congratulations. What I'm going to do is I'm going to get your address off you. Yeah? I'm going to send you loads of good stuff out. It's going to be things like comics, pop culture things, Star Trek Enterprise stuff, Doctor Who stuff. You know, you'll get it. Can't believe you won that, Robert. But it's a handy little program, that is. I'm going to use it more often, I think. Hazby, it's called. H-A-Z-B-Y. And all you do is you download the YouTube video to it, and it analyzes the comments, and then you can use the comments like a database. So so what was it? Anthony Oates, Robert Beveridge, and Chris Morris. Okay, cool. We're all good. So I'm glad we've done that. But listen, thank you all for supporting Mrs. Welder Wayne. Her videos have had over 4,000 views. I've actually got her doll's house over here. And she's already done two more videos, although they're completely unedited at the moment. I still need to edit them. And for what I understand, the third one she's done, she's made so many mistakes on, it's going to make my life hell to try and edit it for her. So you missed quite a bit, apparently. You did, Synth Lord. I was at the Maker Fair. You see, I wanted to show you some images of Maker Fair. I did show you on social media just some images of the Knight Rider car, the DeLorean from Back to the Future, the Ecto one, and the spinner from Blade Runner. Lou, I didn't even realise they had a spinner there. So what I'm going to do is, you've seen on social media, I've done the portrait videos. I actually took loads of landscape videos as well. And if I can, stand by. I'm going to, let me see if I can put one up to just to show you what it looks like. Just the spinner anyway, because I know... you know how much I love Blade Runner. when this is on here, it won't be making. Well, hey, it won't make a noise. So I won't make a noise. Stand by. Right. So media source. Let me think if I can figure this out. Browse. that drive. God, I should have had this ready. Right, let me just try and find. I think it was that one. Yeah, let's go with that one. Let's have a look. Okay, this I think is the spinner. How cool is that? I think I had another video as well, actually. Let me just have a check. Was it this one? God, that was quick, didn't it? God, I took little snippets here. I'm probably going to put these together for a... and this one as well. Chris Morris, I will. I'm going to email you because you won a prize, mate. But hello from Georgia. I'm going to be posting some stuff out to Georgia. I'm going to need to check on a map where that is. I don't know if I've got any more. Let's have a look just at the spinner. I'll show you some of the. I had one of the. Here's some of the car here. Quite a. You get the idea. I am trying to try and get a video together, but it was a great show, I have to say. I really enjoyed the show. But and they had the Ecto one there as well. Can I do the Ecto one? Okay, I'll do one more, just the Ecto one. Seeing as we're coming to the end of that build now. And I did get to meet the Staffordshire Ghostbusters as well. That was pretty cool. And I got to meet the Staffordshire Ghostbusters, as you just saw in the background there. So, had a thoroughly good time. And Mrs. Welder Wayne liked it as well. Have you saw? I did see that. Look, Will, did you miss it? Look. See? All done. So I'm going to send one of these out to you as well, Will. I tried to use a bigger plaque, like I said. My cutting plate's not big enough, unfortunately. So I'm going to have to do that. But I need to paint these and get them sanded as well. So it was a good convention. You never got into Blade Runner, huh? You see, I'm not the only person who thinks it then, Robert. I don't know what it is about Blade Runner. More so of the sequel. I've said it before. It just drags. It reminds me of a Chris Nolan film. It just drags. But, you know, that's just me. But, I mean, I like other things from that era. I think, when was I doing that? I did a Patreon video yesterday, and I was talking about I watched Close Encounters. Of the Third Kind. I haven't seen that film in ages, but I can't believe how good it was. And I remember that the end reminded me a lot of Dueling Banjos from Deliverance, how the scientists and the ships are communicating with each other. But I think it's great. Blade Runner is horrible. Oh my God, we're gonna be starting a row into stream here. This isn't good. Okay, so tonight we are building the F40. Now, obviously, we've done the engine. We've got three parts to add to the engine, and then we're going to start working on the bodywork. And I've got a massive piece of bodywork on the floor down here. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to show you some of the instructions of what we are actually doing, and you can see on here what we've got to do. Because, like, for example, put down the floor, we're going to be starting in issue 69, but everything that comes in issue 69 we're not using. Where have you heard that before? It's all the DB5, isn't it? One last thing, partwork upgrades are selling the Terminator 2 hand goblet at the moment. And hopefully, let's see if I could do this. If I go like this, there it is. And that's in the Partwork Upgrade store at the moment. So if you want to drink your rum like a champion, then you've got some T-800 hand goblet glass official merchandise Judgment Day. Looking like that. That's on the Partwork Upgrade sites. Kits, fixes, mods, props and files if you want to navigate to that. I have got the link here, which I'll put in chat for you as well. There you go. God, technically, I think I'm bang on it tonight to say that I did this at the last minute. Well done for getting Joel, by the way, everybody. Why you? Why me? Why you? Oh, why you? Oh, is that a why you? Apparently, Blade Runner. Yeah, apparently, David. I was watching Prometheus. They're all set in that sort of thing. I don't know what Alien has got to do with Blade Runner. To be honest with you, I think it's just been written that way. The story's molded itself that way. But if you tried to say Alien and Blade Runner were the same when Alien first came out, I don't think you'd find a match. But who knows? Who knows? I don't know that much about it. I'm about to be schooled. I know I am. I'm about to be taught a lesson. Mrs. Wilder Wayne's videos are going to be out on Saturdays, just so you know. So Saturday is Mrs. Wilder Wayne Day. Like Wednesday, we've got Wheelie Wednesday tomorrow where we're going to be doing the Ducati again. But I've got to try and get to it because at the moment my Spitfire stands on there. And if I haven't chucked it out the window, then we'll get going on that. So it's all good. Okay, squirrel moment that was. So overhead camera. So this was the engine that we were working on. Now, if I can just put that to one side just for a second. And I'm going to show you this magazine. And this is what I'm talking about. First of all, there's the centerfold. The Ferrari F333 SP 1999. And then when we get to what we're actually doing, we get loads of parts for the door, as you can see. But we're not doing that. Why do we want to do that? We don't even have to open the pack. We're going to dig out some parts which came in issue 29. Bearing in mind, this is 69. So, you know, it's 40 issues later on. We need those parts here. We've also got another part to put on, another detail, which looks just like this. As a matter of fact, I've already dug this one out. That looks like that there. That came in issue 63. And we've got to push that on as well. These are pushing. So it's only going to take three things to push on in this stage. What do you think of that, huh? Okay, so I've got to figure this out because now the instructions are here aren't very good. They're not very good at all. So by the look of it, stand by. Figuring this one out. Let's look at the picture again. It sort of goes on here, but if one's going on here like that, how can I get the other one on? Stand by. We've got some pegs, just seeing if there's a hole. Can't see any hole. Well, that makes no sense at all. Take out connections A and B from issue 29. Position connection B as shown in the image, aligning with the pin highlighted by the arrow. Highlighted by the arrow. I'm just seeing if there's a difference between these. Stand by. Doesn't make sense. Ah, right. So this one has got a little indent here. So if that is highlighting with that there, then that's going to go on like that. That doesn't make sense. No, that's wrong. This has got that same one in there. So that's got to fit on top like this. Little help, anybody? Ah, wait a minute. I've got it. I think I've got it. Well, no. Oh, my God. Right, this bit definitely goes here. Somehow. Kind of like this. How to get it to stay on there, I don't know. In the picture, this is how this looks, just so you know. I might end up gluing that on there. Something just fell off. Where did these come from? Oh, this is the box for the blower. Car crash Tuesday. It's striking again. Right, I've got to put these back on. Stand by. That goes on here. Kind of. oh my God. Where's the... Bear with me. I've got to get this out. Put this back in. Oh dear. I haven't glued this, so that's probably why it's just falling out here. Now, I do understand, someone told me in this build, they're going to ask me to take a lot of this stuff out again, which I don't really want to do. There you go. Then I can push this, whoops, wrong way, back in. Oh my God. I can't believe this bit's fallen out. And this is nothing to do with this stage. yeah, we're off to a very good start, aren't we? I can't even get this bit down. I'm trying to... Oh, there we go. Got it. I've got it. Right, so I'm putting this back in before it decides to fall out. I'm going to have to glue this in, aren't I? Let me just put this back in so I don't touch it. Like that. Okay. Now, in the picture, this is definitely going like that. But it asked me to use two, but they've only put one in. Complete the part by pushing connection A and B together using the holes. Oh, right. Okay. Hang on. Right. Okay. So this side goes onto this side here. Gotcha. So we're making one complete piece. That makes more sense. Right. Okay. I'm matching it up. But then this is going to be going around this section here. So I need to do that while everything's in place there. I guess. The trouble is, this isn't going together very easy. See, I can't clip this in. God. I hate this build with a passion. Why are they making it so hard? Just checking that I'm putting the light, it is in the right way. We got there. Put it on the car first, then push together. You'd think, Ian, but look, I can't even get it together when it's not on the car. I don't know what I've done now. Let me look again. I've broke one already. Let me snip that off because I don't want that to get in the way. Right, okay. So it's quite easy. One bit's going to go in here and one bit's going to go in there. You'd think. It can't go in any other way. I've got one bit in, right. But I need to be able to put that round here. Let me make sure this is on the right way. And it's fallen off again. So that this bit is round the top. So it's definitely going to be going that way round. Right. So it's going to go that way round onto this section here somehow. I thought this would be the easiest blimmin' stage of this. How wrong am I? Aha. I think I've kind of got it. I think I've got to just line this area up here. But you know what? I'm keeping that there for the minute until I can figure out what's going on. Oh. It doesn't fit together very well at all, these two. This is the problem. I've got it in, but it's not in properly. And I don't want to break it. I'll revisit that afterwards, but that's in just like that. And then we've got this detail here to put in. Let's see if we can figure that one out. Yeah, I thought they said three issues. You know what I'm like. Okay, this one is going in. Aha, look, I know this one. We've got two holes just at the top there. We're going to be pushing this into those two holes like this. One and two, and there we go. And that is all there is to do in that stage. That was a nightmare. I can't believe how hard that is. But I probably am going to revisit that afterwards because I'm not happy with that. Crazy. Crazy stage. Name featured on the card at the end of every video. What's that? Stream Elements is off on one again today, I see. Okay, so stage 70. This is where it's going to get fun now. We have got the centerfold. which I've got past, which is the Ferrari 735S. But check this out. We get to start the bodywork. We're putting the fuel cap on. And that's pretty much it. but we've got the bodywork. So let's get this out. I've got this somewhere down here. Swear jar at the ready. I'm going to need it. This is massive. Check that out. I've had this for a while, you know. It's just I haven't done anything with it. So I've been looking at it, basically. Now, I'll tell you now, there's nowhere in the man cave that this can go. Got some bits in here. Fuel cap and some screws by the look of it. Nothing else. Let's get this out. This is fun. Oh, like Christmas. Get these bits off here. Ooh, this looks nice. Needs a bit of a clean. I don't think I've got a cloth. I have got a cloth. Let me just double check. Seen better days, this cloth. It's going to need a polish up. It does polish up though. But that, when I'm dropping everything, is the frame. I'll have your F40 world away and I'm sure we can figure something out. So there you go. That looks just like that. So what we're going to be doing is we're going to be putting the fuel filler cap on onto this side here. So I'll get this out. I do like how they do have things individually wrapped in here. There you go. I've set a positive. So this has got a little hinge on there. So that's going to go in just like that. I'm going to turn it upside down, which means I am now using my part work upgrades, Matt, because I don't want to get this damaged. And on the other side of this, we have got a link, which will go over the top like that and stop that falling out. And we're holding that in here with a size H screw, which I've lost my screwdriver. Oh, there it is. See, so this stage wasn't too bad. There we go. Get that in. I should have put that in oil, really. Let me, heavy duty screwdriver time. You saw how tight I got that with the wearer. Look, check this out. This is with the heavy duty one. Look, I got about another two turns out of that. Cool. So that's the fuel filler cap in. Not quite sure how. Oh, there we go. We open it just like that. And down. Perfect. You've been faffing around with Warhammer figures. Tapping the hatch helps. What hatch? I'm tapping things. And that's it. That's all we've got to do in that stage. That was a quick one, wasn't it? So are we in? I'll put that to one side. Stand by. I'm balancing that over here. Put that on the floor. Get rid of my rubbish because we need to work tidy. And then we go to issue 71, where we have got the Ferrari 500 TR looking like that. And in this one, we're doing something to do with the doors by the look of it. So let me get this right. Take out the door window from issue 66. Okay, I need to find that. Fix the hinge connection plate that came with issue 67. I need to find that. Place the grill that came from issue 67. I need to dig out issue 67. I think I've got it here, and we're pretty much going to have the door in place. Let's hope. Now, if I just move cameras back, I keep all of this stuff behind me. So hopefully I can find this. I'm sure if we had the door and we didn't use it, I wouldn't have opened the pack. So I'm just going to have a quick check and see what I can find. 1 second. So issue 66. Let's have a look what we got. I wouldn't have opened the pack. I'm sure I wouldn't. Ah, there, I didn't. Issue 66. There we go. Order 66. Get everything out here. We've got screws in there. And we've got some window and glass. I think that's the first thing we're going to need. I'd make sure both doors fit because many, including myself, have had issues with the driver's side not fitting at all. Oh, great. Adrian, you're filling me with optimism. You just want your R2-D2 parts. You still not received anything, Howard. That's not good. That looks nice, though. I do like the bodywork for this. I'm going to bring up the mat again. I don't want to scratch this. So, let's figure this one out. We want it this way round. And we're going to be putting the window into place over. over. I've got it the right way first time. How's this going? Two and one. Oh, over those bits just there. Like that. And that's going to be held in with some type G screws. I didn't see any G screws. I've got S. There was nothing in that pack. Just checking. Issue 66. No. Which means I need to go through this box of tricks again and find G screws. 1 second. R. N. C. V. W. T. R. H. Oh, G screws. Just checking if I've got any more. I've got some in issue 67. We're probably going to need them from issue 67, but I'll take them out here anyway so I get an idea what size they are. G screws. Okay, now we need... We've only got two of them here. They're flange screws. Just see what I've got in here. They're the same as those. All right, okay. I've got plenty of them. Cool. Simples. So we need, let me think. Oh, now they're saying they're silver. I haven't got any silver ones. We've got S's. They're not flanged. Stand by. I'm having a moment. Fit the hinge and connection plate. Okay, it says, take out the door and window from issue 60. Combine the two... Wait a minute, they're saying S screws. Where did I get G from? Oh, that's the next stage. Okay. Car crash Tuesday. Car crash Tuesday. So the screws that actually came with it are the ones we need. There's a shock. I don't know what makes this build hard. The bad instructions or the bad builder. So that's one. I can't believe that. If I didn't have a camera pointed at me, this wouldn't be bad at all. That's number two. And then finally, we're going to do number three. Obviously, this window slides open here, as you can see, and closed. Although it's not very good. Open and close. There we go. Get the other one out here. Now, what I do like about this, I think the S-screws are overkill. Yeah, definitely. What I do like about this is everything that we're working on here after this stage is actually in the packs, I believe. We don't have to go digging around for another pack. But there we go. That's the window in. Then we need stage 67, which I just got out there. What did I do with it? It's here. And we need the hinges out of it, which look like... stand by. Look like that, and also should be a plate in here somewhere. That one there, and that's when we're going to need the G screw, which I've already got here. So these hinges are pretty much like all the 1.8 vehicles we've got. Definitely the Mustangs. I think the Ecto 1 had this as well. So the way these go is basically this will be going into the channel there, and then this goes this way round, holding it into place. And then I'll put a G screw. Not that one. Stand by. Get in there. Don't want to lose this. Just in through that side there. Like that. Excellent. You melted a spur gear in two battery packs. Oh my God. World away would probably be banned from YouTube, probably. So there we go. So now it has got like this. Can you see how that locks in by itself? That's how these hinges work on these builds. Okay, so that's the hinging. What else we got to do? We're actually working on stage 67 still, even though this is stage 71. So I might as well get the rest of this stuff out of here now. See what I mean about it being confusing? Stage 71 and we're working on stage 67. Crazy. Okay, now this section here, I don't know if you can tell, is plastic. So we're working on the plastic side here, and we've got a grill to put in. And this is just going to be pushed over this side. It's going to be the black side facing towards us. So when it's over these pegs here, which I'm having an enormous amount of problem lining this sort of thing up tonight, when you look through it, it gives that effect, which is quite a neat little effect there. I like that. Okay, once we've done that, we have got to put to fix the cover of the windows lifting system used for. So we've got a cover for the windows lifting system, which must be. They're not helping me. They're not helping me. It must be this. That's what they're talking about. And that's going to go in. Standby. So from that side, I can see this. So it's going to go in like that. So it looks like that from that side. And that from that side. That's going to be held in with T-screws. Oh, I've got T-screws. We're happy. Take care, John Hay. You know what? I want to do a blooper video, Scott Mitchell. And last year, I really wanted to do it for Christmas. But I lost all my data. I believe in... Was it before my holiday? June, July time? It might have been a bit later than that. But it wiped everything that I had. I've been saving up for the year. But as a nice treat to myself... If I didn't explain it on stream, I don't think I did actually. As a treat to myself... While I'm not having accidents, I'm allowed to keep the board like that. No accident zone. If I have an accident, then I've got to go through the daily routine of changing it. And I'm hoping that will be a bit of aversion therapy for me. So I don't keep doing stupid accidents. Okay. So. That looks just like that. Pretty impressive. We're going to match this off now with the door, I believe. So this... is going on like this somehow. Stand by. Like that. There we go. That looks good. I can't get this down though. Am I putting this in the wrong place? Probably. We've got lugs in here, as you can see, and we're pushing them onto these sections here. So it's just a case of lining these lugs up, which, believe it or not, isn't that easy. What? I'm trying to line the top ones up first. There we go. Which should hopefully line up these bottom ones. Now, I don't know. Is that meant to fit flush? Ah, yeah. There you go. Perfect. Just checking that all the way around. So that now looks like that. That was quite an easy way to put a door together, I have to say. We've got the door catch to put on here. That looks like this. And then once again, this is just going to be pushed in with lugs. You know, they over-engineer the engine and make things really hard and put screws in. But with this door, it's just all being pushed together with lugs. There's hardly any screws in it at all. That doesn't make any sense at all. And that is finished. So that's that stage 71 complete. I like that. I like that a lot. Okay. Once again, quick tidy up, and we get onto the last stage. Put that over there. Let's get that on the floor. Here's an idea. Do you take pics of the workshop evolving? It hasn't evolved that much at the moment, but yes, I normally do. As a matter of fact, I do kind of like looking at my old YouTube videos to see how it has evolved, especially from the old man cave. That was quite bare when I first changed it. But this place is just getting bigger and bigger. As you can see, I've got the retro shelf, Revo Dave's helmet there. And probably in about, I don't know, 4 or 5 weeks, I'll have something completely different in here. Obviously, the Ecto-1 and me Slimers go into Svi. So I will have something on that shelf. There's something that I've got in line to go on that shelf. Lou knows what's going to go on that shelf. But you'll find out about that soon. Oh, bless. Wayne, has the light set to low intensity tonight? Low intensity? What light? The light in here? Where's my little thing? See, now, the lights that I've got on the camera, if I go to that, I can actually make that brighter. Kind of. But I don't want to wash it out. So, as you can see, I can change the gain on this. Make it a bit brighter. And when I do colour correcting, I look at my hands and I don't want my hands to be washed out. But there you go. Look, I've made it a little bit brighter tonight. How's that? At the expense of, I don't know what I'm doing here. Gonna need a bigger shed. Tell me about it, Mike. Okay, so stage 72. No idea what we're doing. Let's go to the centre page again. We got the Ferrari 121 LM looking like that. Turn around and we're going to be doing the left hand sill. So we've got some parts here which came in stage 68. We're doing stage 72, but I need all the all the parts from stage 68 and 69. But wait a minute, 69 was the one. Hang on, stand by. Right, so 69 is the one that we started this stream on. So I need that. We've got this part here, which came for this stage, which by the look of it, we don't need. They've given us a seal, but we don't need it. Oh, God. And I need to find 68, so. Aha. 68, which has got the other door in it, which is interesting. Is that what we're doing? We are. We're doing the other door. This is so confusing. Right, okay. let's put this mat back up here again, then. Can you see why I hate this build now? Right. Let's get all of this out. Yeah, that was just mood lighting, Robert Beveridge. I thought we'd have some mood lighting tonight. Okay. Just checking I haven't got any screws in here. Obviously, these doors are metal. Once again, we're opening up this window. Make sure there's nothing in there. Turn this over. And then just like last time, we're going to be putting this into the channel there and holding that in with size S screws. Where's my screwdriver? What's 24? What are you talking about? Why is everyone saying 25 and 24? Yeah, the more space you have, the more stuff you fill. It's true. If you ever move from a large house to a small house, I don't know how you could do it. I'm going to need to, when I put the next screw in, as a matter of fact, I'm going to do it on this one. We need to put oil in this. I've got the S screws. They were here, Ed. Put some oil in this because they're going in a little bit difficult. Whoops, the daisies. Oh, damn it. I'm trying not to touch the window because let's put the middle one in first. There you go, that's better. That oil just so makes a difference. It is a little bit harder on this one, though, I have to say. Is this the door we're having problems with? Is that... Not a clue about 24. Do you sell your models? Not really, no. I normally give them away... who's that? M. Bond M. I normally give them away. I have a lot of joy. I have a lot of joy building models. And some of my personal favourites I'll never sell. I'll never get rid of my Orca or my ET spaceship. This is asking for trouble, I know it is. That's better. I need to get some welly behind this, you see, so... This is an accident waiting to happen, isn't it? These are really tight to get in. The last one here. Perfect. There we go. We've got a window in once again. Open and close. Open and close. Cool. Once again, we've got the panel to put in, which, looking around, is coming with issue... Oh, the hinge first. Issue 69 is what we started this stream at. Let's get everything out here. Perfect. Just finding all the parts for the hinge. I've got that part. Put the hinge and hinge plate in. Ah, the hinge was in here, wasn't it? Get this one open. Did I say welly? I hope so. Normally if I'm giving it some welly, I mean some... I'm really giving it some force. I think it's a cockney thing, welly. I don't know. I ain't got a clue. I don't know where I picked these stuff up from. So we need the flange G screw in there. I remember that bit. Get that out. Drop that in some oil. Never know. We might have a Ferrari soon. I've got quite a few issues of this here, just so you know. That's why I'm glad we're doing this tonight. Okay. Get that in as tight as I can get it. Because we want that effect that the door springs when this is open. As a matter of fact, I'll just cock something up there. No, there we go. Just like that. Perfect. Okay, we got the plate. Move that over to put in on this section here. Once again, look, more G-screws. Don't chuck away the screws on this build. Stream Elements is really going off on one tonight. I don't know what that's all about. Okay, so once again we're putting the grill side facing outwards, so that's going to go in here, line up the lugs just like this. One, oops. Tell them on the final run things are going completely wrong. Right, try that again. Come on. One, two, three, there we go. Push them down. Perfect. So that looks like that. Excellent. We've got the door catch to fit in a second. I think, do they want me to put this in first? They want me to put the inside window in. Inside window? What am I talking about? Inside panel. Which is going to go in that way, I believe. So that looks like that. That's held in with size T screws, I think. Yep. Give you a McLaren F1 any day. I'd like the Testarossa. I know there is a part work build for a Testarossa as well. That would be the ideal Ferrari for me to build. Hinges upside down. Really? Does it matter? It's the right way round. I don't think it matters. It opens. Hello? Yeah, I know, and I'm saying, does it matter?
Okay. That's how you want to be,
Mrs. Attitude. Oh, bless. Does it matter, really? Is hinge the wrong way round? I don't know. Let me look at the picture again. It's not the wrong way round. They're saying it's back to front. Stand by. Does it matter? I'm just looking. There's no lip on it. I don't think it matters. Let me have a look. This is why we'd make these mistakes. I don't think it matters. So if I turn it that way around, it's not going to matter. Oh, you're talking about this one here. Is that what you're talking about? You are talking about that. Duh.
Wayne, come on. Car crash Tuesday stream. Yeah, I'm on the sofa tonight. Look, I was wrong. I ain't going to hear the end of that. You know that, didn't you? Oh, my God. I think I had the hinge the wrong way around. So the hinge needs to be on that way. That's better. What an idiot. I'm not going to hear the end of it. Thank you, peeps, for that. A, you stopped me going wrong. And B, Mrs. Welder Wayne's now got something that she's just never going to let me live down. That's not good. Esther is the boss. I cannot believe that. I'm not going to hear the end of that. Okay, let's finish this. That's terrible. Okay, we're going to put this this section in here just like last time, which means lining up the top lugs. Oh, here we go. What's that? I'll apologise. I'm sorry. Damn it. Okay, I'm just trying to push this in. Looks okay there. The bottom ones don't want to go in. So I'm looking. I'm looking. They're lined up. Oh, that's 2 in. 3 in. 4 in. I think we're good. 4 in. Shit, Lord of the Rings fans. 4 in. That tickled me. There you go. That's that one in. I can't believe that tickled me. 4 in. 4 in Oakenshield. Okay, so there's the next door catching. Just like that. And that is another completed door. So we have done 2 completed doors, put a petrol cap on, and then before I finish with this bit, I'm going to move these over here, get rid of this, move this over here, and I think we'll just finish up looking at what the hell is going on with this here. Because I don't think that's on where it needs to be. I'm going to have a takeoff of this. We have got this little bit of a catch on here, which is going to go over that little bit of a catch there. The trouble is that I don't think this can go in. I think it's going to have to sit quite far back on there. Just looking at that. Now you have got this little tab here, which is obviously going into this one here, but I don't know. I just don't think it's sitting very well. I can push one of these in quite nicely, but it does leave quite a nasty gap. If I can show you that, now the brightness has been turned up. Stand by. Try to get this in. See, look, you can't, unless I glue it, I suppose, you've still got quite a big seam at the top there. And that's with that lug in. I don't know. Why they've made this into 2 sections like this, I don't know, without screws. But if I put that together, that's together without it on there. And look, you've got this unsightly hole here. I don't know what that's for. And that ginormous seam down the middle, which you can't really get rid of. Don't put together before, do on the car. Yeah, no, I can do that, Ian. But what I'm saying is, when that's on the car, you're going to have that seam. Because that's together. You see what I mean? I don't like that. Check to see if the doors fit. Shall I do that? Let me bung this on. Stand by. Probably can't get this bit off now. I will put this bit on the car in a second. Oh, and it goes on that way, doesn't it? I will figure that bit out after the stream. It's going to go on, not that way. I'll figure that out. Let's have a look at these doors. People are saying the doors aren't going to fit. So there's the car. This is the door that would go in here. Which I'm looking. Stand by. Ah, I see what you mean. It's a bit weird. Looking at how this goes. I've got a door catch in here, which is going to go there. Oh God, that don't look like it fits at all. I think you're right. Let me check. Try this one, and I'll show you what it looks like. Hang on. That one's a little bit better, but obviously these aren't in where they need to go. Yeah. What door are we having the problem with? Are we talking about this door here on what would be the British side? It's not a perfect fit. No, it's not. Just looking at that again. I don't think I can make that any better. Let me... Wow. I don't think it's twisted either. Just looking at it. Look at the difference here. Look. That's that door. Look at the line around the top there. Okay. Not too bad, is it? Check this side out. Whoops. Put that back in again. Check that out. What's this all about here? Look at that. Any ideas? Yeah, it's the gift that definitely keeps on giving. Is there a fix for that, Ian Longley? I can't see how. It's not twisted. Is the door a different shape? I'm just lining up the lines of the door here. And I don't think that is... That's crazy. The line at the bottom is perfectly smooth here. It's just this window line. It's completely out. No, that can't be right. Yeah, aircon. I think it would be. The amount of gap in here. This door... Is this dramatically different from this one? I've got to look now. Let me have a look at this. So these windows... I'm wondering. They're kind of like the same shape. I'm wondering if we might have to manually mount these windows in here to get that. Window panels and roof panels to go on later. I think once you get the other pieces on, it will fit better. Tight to the front. Yeah, it was tight to the front. That was weird. Why would one door, though, go on perfect and the other door have that gap? And it's not a small gap either. You're looking about 2 or 3 mil. Gonna have to think of that one. I'm wondering if is that a common problem then? Because obviously I've just noticed it now. What issue was that? That went to issue 72. Now I've got up to issue 85 here. 86. I've got a lot. Window not incorrectly on that door. What? Looking again. It can't... Yeah, it is. I'm looking at both doors. It is. On this door, we've got a little bit of an extra sort of lip on it. But look at the beading at the bottom of that. Then look at that one. It's the same. Except this one's just got this extra bit at the end of the metal just down this end here. I mean, the window can't go on any other way because it's fitting on those lugs. Are the windows down enough? Again, you can't move them because they have to line up with those holes. But Ian says later stage fixes it. I hope so. I'm going to be looking at that. File the hinge. I will have a look after the stream. I'm going to try and get that vent in first because I don't know what's going on there. But that was fun. That wasn't too much of a car crash. It started off a bit crazy. And obviously Mrs. World Away being proved right is a complete car crash for me tonight because I'm not going to hear the end of it. So... Anyway, listen, thanks for joining me tonight. Tomorrow we're going to be working on the Ducati and patrons. We're going to be doing the live stream tomorrow. We're going to be building the steam-powered UFO. That should be quite fun, which means we'll be working with fire. That can't be good. Anyway, listen, all take care of yourselves, and I will see you later. Naked Gun ending.